I am Dr. G. Jesse John, Assistant Professor, Department of Anatomy, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. Today we are discussing about the anatomy of aorta. The aorta is the greatest artery, largest artery too. It is the great vessels of our heart and carry the oxygenated blood from the left ventricle and it distributes it to the all parts of our body. Parts of aorta, there is some three parts of the aorta specially, that is the ascending aorta, arch of aorta, and descending aorta. But when it descends down and it will go through the thoracic and abdominal region, then it will call thoracic aorta, and if it goes through abdomen region, then it will be called abdominal aorta. Ascending aorta, it has length of 5 cm and diameter of 3 cm, and it is completely enclosed in pericardium. It will arise from the upper end of the left ventricle and continues as an arch of aorta at the sternal angle. It begins behind the sternum at the level of lower border of the left third costal cartilage. Then it will move upwards and forwards and to the right side to continue as the arch of aorta at the level of the sternal angle. So we can see here, it will arise from the left ventricle, then it will continue as arch of aorta at the level of the sternal angle. Aortic sinuses, the root of aorta present 3 dilations, that is called aortic sinus of Valsalva. So we can see here, this is the root of ascending aorta. So we can see here some bulges, some dilation, that is the called sinuses of the aorta. Sinuses of aortic sinus of Valsalva. These position are anterior side and posterior side. In posterior side, it is located in both side, right and left side. So we will call right posterior aortic sinus and left posterior aortic sinus. So from the anterior aortic sinus, there will be origin of right coronary artery and left posterior aortic sinus. There will be origin of left coronary artery, but right posterior aortic sinus, there is no coronary artery, so we will term non-coronary sinus. So we can see here, this is the right side, there is no coronary artery. This is the left side, there is a coronary artery, and again, from the anterior aortic sinus, there is the coronary artery. So branches will be these coronary arteries, the right coronary artery and the left coronary artery. Relations, the anterior side, there is the infundibulum, right ventricle, pulmonary trunk and pericardium. In posterior side, there is transverse sinus of pericardium, right pulmonary artery, right principal bronchus, and to the right side, there is right atrium, superior vena cava, and to the left side, left atrium and pulmonary trunk. Arch of aorta is continuation of the ascending aorta at the level of the sternal angle, and it continues as descending thoracic aorta at the level of the sternal angle. So we can see here, it is beginning from the ascending aorta at the level of the sternal angle, and it will terminate as a descending thoracic aorta at the same level, that is the sternal angle. So, and it is situated in the superior mediastinum. Course, it will begin at the level of the right second costal cartilage, then it will move upwards, backwards, and to the left side. After reaching the back of the manubrium, it turns backwards and somewhat downwards behind the left bronchus, up to the level of the lower border of the T4 vertebra, then it will continue as the descending thoracic aorta. Branches, brachiocephalic artery, that is the trunk, and it will give rise some arteries, that is the left right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery, and this is the independent arteries, that is the left common carotid artery and left subclavian artery, that directly arise from the arch of aorta. Descending thoracic aorta. Descending thoracic aorta is the continuation of the arch of aorta, and that is also situated in the posterior mediastinum. It begins on the left side of the lower border of the fourth thoracic vertebra and descends in posterior mediastinum and terminates in front of the lower border of the 12th thoracic vertebra. Then it will go to the aortic opening of the diaphragm, and then it will reach in abdominal region and it will be called abdominal aorta. Parietal branch, it has some branches, that is the parietal branches and visceral branches. The parietal branches are 3 to 11, posterior intercostal artery and subcostal artery. And in visceral branches are 2 left bronchial arteries and esophageal branches. Clinical conditions, aortic uncle. The aortic uncle may become prominent in old age because of the undue folding that is caused by the atherosclerosis, and that is the common conditions in the old age. Coarctation of aorta, it is a congenital narrowing of the aorta, that is the just proximal or distal to the entrance of the ductus arteriosus. Patent ductus arteriosus, in fetal life, pulmonary trunk are connected to arch of aorta by a channel that is called ductus arteriosus. After birth, it is closed, but sometime it remain open. So there is a condition that is the mixing of the blood, that is the deoxygenate blood, oxygenate blood. So there will be condition that is happened by the lower level of the oxygen in the blood. Aneurysm of the arch of aorta, it is localized dilation of the arch, and it causes compression of the neighboring structures, and mostly there is a tubal structures in side of the aorta in the superior mediastinum. So the compression causes many type of the symptoms that is constitute a syndrome that is called mediastinal syndrome. So we discussed all the aspects of the aorta. And if you have any query, any doubts, please contact me. Otherwise, please write down below here. Thank you. Thank you so much.